your neighbors across the country buy more food packages carrying this brand than any other in the world. And now, Borden's presents TV's newest and liveliest panel show, Make the Connection. And now let's meet our Make the Connection panel, the star of Life with Elizabeth, Betty White, disc jockey humorist Gene Klavan, Hollywood actress and singing star Gloria DeHaven, star of the Broadway show The 7-Year Itch, Eddie Bracken, our moderator, the bright young television comedian Gene Rayburn, and Borden's guest tonight, the former school teacher from Brooklyn, Sam Levinson.
These empty plates represent 16 hungry kids waiting for the treat of the party, Borden's ice cream. And I can fill every dish from just one of Borden's half-gallon cartons. Oh, what a lifesaver when a youngster's birthday comes around. Of course, I'm keeping another half-gallon in reserve, because with an ice cream as delicious as Borden's, they're bound to want seconds. But then in this house, somebody always wants Borden's ice cream for a cone or a soda in the middle of the afternoon, or for dessert at dinner time, or a snack later on. And with Borden's half gallons, there's always enough to keep everybody happy. Yes, my good friend Elsie, her picture's on the package, you know. She's got a mighty good thing in this half gallon size. It saves you time and money, too, so it pays you to get Borden's ice cream in half gallons. Just be sure you buy the ice cream with Elsie on the carton.
They called me and they said, we want you to host a game show. And they go, you are so perfect for this. You're the only one. You're the top of the list. I go home and I tell my wife, and he gave me a tape.
Deal or No Deal, a TV phenomenon sweeping the world.
And I went, oh my God, this is the most dramatic, amazing thing. And I said, I'll do it. When do you start? And they said, we're shooting Monday. This is Friday. And I go, you said I'm on the top of the list. You are. Well, don't you have to build a set? We have a set. How far down the list was I that they were begging me? Got a call from CBS Casting. And I was like, hey, maybe they want me to do a CSI. He goes, how would you like to take over for Bob Barker on The Price is Right? And I was like, what? No. At the end of that meeting, I decided to do the show. Because the producer of the show, he asked me, he goes, what's your favorite thing to do? And I said, I love to leave big tips. And he goes, well, on The Price is Right, you get to do that every day.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this session of Make the Connection. I'm really delighted to be here as a moderator of this unique panel show, and it is a unique panel show, because as far as I know, it's the only panel show in existence that doesn't have Audrey or Jane Meadows on the panel. Not that we wouldn't like to have them, but it's unusual in that respect. As you know, the panel is going to try to make the connection between two or more contestants, and I guess I needn't remind so witty and bright a group of people as you about the rules, except that it says I have to do it here, and I'm going to do it. You know that you can question our contestants as long as the light in front of you is on. There it is. Now, when the light goes out and things blow up, our contestants get $25. Then, when they've won $150, the game is over. You've had it, you see. That's all there is to it. You understand that?
No.
You don't. Well, then you better explain it to me. No, I guess you do understand that because you've been playing the game most proficiently and I've been watching you. Now, let's meet our first pair of guests. Down, please. All right. Real close to me. Would you tell us your name and where you're from, please?
Mrs. William Miller from Long Beach, Long Island.
All right, and you, sir?
Mr. William Miller.
Oh, you must be Mr. Miller then, and you two are married, is that right?
That's right.
Okay, now for the benefit of our audience, let's make the connection.
Mr. Miller is a policeman who gave his wife a parking ticket last week.
All right, panel, I'll give you this one little link here in this connection. This is something that Mr. Miller did to Mrs. Miller. Now, let's start the questioning with Betty White.
Oh, this is something you did to Mrs. Miller. Is that right, Mr. Miller?
That's right.
Have you ever done it to any other women?
Oh, yes.
Yes, he has.
Since you've been married?
Yes.
Sure.
Yeah.
Probably especially since you've been married.
Mrs. Miller, do you get jealous?
No.
Did you enjoy this?
No, I didn't.
Did you enjoy it, Mr. Miller?
No.
Well, if nobody enjoyed it, what'd you do it for?
Okay, that's $25 down, $125 to go. And now let's hear from Gene Claven.
Mr. and Mrs. Miller, first of all, welcome to Bride and Groom. Did this have anything to do with the geographical location of Long Beach, New York, at all?
Yes, it did, in a way.
Could you have four of us out to go swimming tomorrow? Was it something that you would continue to do, Mr. Miller?
Yes.
Was there another person involved?
Yes.
Mrs. Miller,
Strictly speaking, at the time the connection happened, there was no other persons involved. Subsequently, other people became involved, but we're not interested in that at all.
Mr. Miller, were there other people involved?
Your light is growing dim.
Yes. Mrs. Miller, was there an object involved here?
Yes, there was. Yes, there was an object involved.
Was it something that we would use? Here, you know, any one of us?
No.
No, not here.
No, not here.
We're a pretty motley crew. We wouldn't use it. Would it be used in an average home?
I think the average person has it.
You're faded.
The average person has encountered...
I don't care anymore, Gene. My light's out.
All right. That's $50 down, $100 to go, and now we want to hear from Gloria DeHaven.
I wish mine was non. Mr. Miller, I didn't hear this. Hear you say this. Does this have anything to do with your profession? I didn't hear you say...
Yes.
Yes, it does.
It does.
Yes, indeed. You're on the track.
There she goes now. All right.
Coming around the far turn. Go ahead, Gloria.
It has something to do with your profession, and therefore, you have done this to Mrs. Miller, and you've done it to other women, too, as part of your profession, right?
Yes.
I see. Are you a doctor?
No.
She's thinking again.
I know it hurts. Well, that's $75 down, $75 to go. Eddie, do you have any ideas?
Well, I don't know whether I have any ideas or not, but I'd like to find out. Your job has something to do with, are you in the business world, are you?
No, he's not in the business world.
Are you in a professional field?
It would not be considered a profession, I don't believe.
It would not be considered a profession?
In the sense, you know, that lawyers and doctors...
I see. But it is a specialized... A job that he would do?
Yes. Requires training of some kind.
It does. You train long for this? I mean, do you go to school to learn how to do this?
Yes.
You've had it, friends. I don't... you're getting fairly close to it, but I don't think you're going to get it. We're going to give our contestants the full $150, and here's the story. Mr. Miller is a policeman, and he gave his wife a parking ticket last week. Tell me, Mr. Miller, when you wrote out the ticket, did you know that it was a family car you were hanging the ticket on?
Yes, I did.
You did? But you did it anyway.
That's right.
Because the law is the law. And did you pay the fine?
Yes, I did. And he explained to me, after all, it's only fair to other motorists. I was only being fair. And if you want me to be a good cop, I have to be a good cop all the way.
Well, that's pretty laudable, I
say. Boom, boom, boom.
Did she try to talk you out of it or anything?
Did she try and talk you out of it?
No, I was swimming at the time.
Oh, I see.
Could I ask something?
Yes, you may.
Did you take it out of the household money?
No, I get $2 a week to go to the movies. I just didn't go to the movies this week.
Oh, how silly.
Well, we know that the community of Long Beach is very proud to have Patrolman Miller on the staff out there. We thank you. Incidentally, close your eyes as you leave the theater. Because the green convertible that's double parked on a pedestrian is mine. But just don't pay any attention to it. Thank you very much for playing Make the Connection with us tonight. Good night. Panel, we're ready to make our second connection. May we have our next guests, please? Good evening. It's nice to have you. I'd like to introduce these people to our panel. On my left here is Miss Renee Pasquette. Where do you live, Miss Pasquette?
New York City.
In New York City. And this is Mr. William Locascio. And where do you live, sir?
New York City.
You live in New York City, too. Now, for the benefit of our audience, let's make the connection.
Mr. Locascio proposed to Miss Pasquette 7 months ago, and Miss Pasquette accepted.
What do you think of that? Here's a little wink to start you off on, panel. This is something Mr. Locascio did to Miss Pasquette. Let's start the questioning with Gloria DeHaven.
Mr. Locascio, this thing that you did to Miss Pasquette, was this in the form of, is this the way you make your living?
No. No.
Well, is it a hobby? Some sort of a hobby?
No hobby.
Do you do it for other women?
No.
You do it for other men? Well, does it take any particular kind of courage to do this?
Yes.
Yes? Not in all cases, but some men consider that it takes a lot of courage.
Oh, well, then did you get some sort of a medal for this?
No, he didn't. That's $25 down, $125 to go. Eddie, what are you, what questions
well,
do you
Ms.
have?
Well, Ms. Pasquette, I must ask, did you enjoy this thing that he did for you?
Oh, yes.
Yes, indeed.
In other words, it made you happy.
Yes.
Well, tell me, was there any gain connected with this? Did you make anything from it? In other words, was money involved?
No, money was not involved, but in kind of a strange sense, both of them gained something from this connection.
They both gained something.
Yes, they did.
Well, would it be anything tangible, something you could hold in your hand?
No, I guess not. No. That's $50 down, $100 to go. Betty, what ideas do you have about this connection?
You know, you're more fun than the question.
Was there an object involved, especially involved, Miss Pasquette?
Not specifically, no. Not at the time the connection was made.
Did anything particularly change hands? If not money, something else?
It will a little bit later, but it did not at the time the connection was made.
Sounds kind of like fun, whatever it is.
Yeah.
Did you enjoy this, Mr. Locascio?
Yes.
It's been established that they both enjoyed it.
Is it something that I would enjoy?
No doubt.
I guess so.
Yes, it would be very flattering to you, Miss White.
Do you know Michael Rennie?
Did this take place recently?
The actual connection did, yes. That's $75 down, $75 to go. Gene Clavin, how are you tonight?
Gene Rayburn.
With the real hard thoughts.
Friends, you are watching the show called The Name's Almost the Same. Mr. Locascio, tonight, we established that you sort of had fun here. And, Miss Pasquette, you sort of had fun on this thing. Well, a heck of it, what was it? Was this a service along the lines of your occupation, sir?
No.
That's been established. Nothing to do with his occupation.
Miss Pasquette had nothing to do with her occupation either. Is the building where it happened important?
No,
that would not help you at all.
And nothing's going to help me. Is the geographical location important?
That would not give you any help at all. That's $100 down, $50 to go. I see that Gloria has some ideas.
Well, it's just a wild chance, but you said some men it would take courage. Does it have anything to do with proposing or...
Yes, it does. As a matter of fact, that's about it. Good for you.
Did it happen just right, very quickly?
Mr. Locascio proposed to Miss Pasquette 7 months ago, and she accepted him this afternoon. And that's the way it is.
Congratulations.
We've known about this situation for some time here, and we've sort of wondered what was going to happen. The thing we'd like to know now, Miss Pasquette, is what the heck took you so long?
Well, a girl can't rush into these things.
That's true. A girl just can't rush into these things now,
yes,
can she?
Yes, she can.
She's got to be real careful.
Miss Pasquette, could I ask you something?
Well,
how come you're so confident?
Incidentally, where were you when she accepted you, Bill?
In the automat.
In the automat?
In 58.
Was it before or after you had your dessert? Do you remember? That doesn't mean. You just ran out of nickels and they were sitting there talking and
he said,
we might as well get married or something like that.
I think he had too many slugs.
Incidentally, since it happened such a short time ago, I don't imagine you've had time to get a ring, have you?
No, we didn't get anything.
Like it's a good thing you didn't, because we sort of anticipated that, and we got one for you, and here it is. Isn't that a beauty?
Hey, Gene,
I'll tell you what.
Gene, she may marry you here. Now, though.
What's that?
She may marry you.
This is an exquisite $500 bridal lock diamond engagement and wedding ring set with absolutely flawless diamonds. They'll put your eye out if you're not careful here. Bridal lock engagement and wedding rings locked together for a perfect match. Now, we've unlocked them, and I guess you can take the wedding ring and put it in your pocket. No, that's the engagement ring. That's the wedding ring. You put that in your pocket. Am I right about this? Sure I am.
Postcard.
And suppose you put the engagement ring on her finger right now. Would you like to do that? Oh. Now, before you go, since you already have the wedding ring, and we hope you'll use it someday, when you do get married, we want you to have a fabulous honeymoon. And we've arranged for that. You'll be the guest of the El Rancho Vegas, the luxurious home of the movie stars in Las Vegas, Nevada. All expenses, including your round-trip transportation, will be taken care of by the El Rancho Vegas. Thank you for appearing us tonight, and best wishes.
Good night. Good night.
I say sweet.
We have an announcement here. The future Mr. and Mrs. Miller invite everybody out there to the wedding sometime in 1987. Because it took this long to get them engaged, it's going to take that long to get them married.
Except you got the name wrong. The Millers, the first couple, are already married. But anyway, we're all invited, friends. In just a moment, you're going to have a chance to make the connection between our guest star, Sam Levinson, and some other gentlemen. But right now, let's relax a minute and revive our weary brains with a fresh new thought about something that's mighty welcome.
Here comes our old friend Elsie with another wonderful Borden treat for your children. She's bringing Dutch cocoa all the way to America for Borden's real Dutch chocolate flavored milk. Where else could you get an imported flavored treat that's so easy to serve? No mixing. You just pour it right from the carton. My young neighbors here really go for that good chocolate flavor. And when they ask why it's called Dutch, I always tell them that Borden's Dutch chocolate milk is flavored the real Dutch way, with the finest imported Dutch cocoa. That's why it's so smooth and rich tasting, like no other chocolate milk they ever drank. It gives your youngsters lots of good milk nourishment, too, like vitamins, minerals, and proteins. And you know how important that is. So treat your children to Borden's Dutch chocolate-flavored milk real soon. They'll love it.
Up next, want to meet Mr. Mischief? Just wait until you see the kids' show Choose Upsides. Then Gene hosts the 1962 pilot of Match Game. Stay tuned.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, here is America's favorite family humorist, the man who's lived in everybody's home, Sam Levinson. Looking pretty sharp there, Sam.
Thank you, Gene.
I understand that you're really setting the television megacycles on fire with your handling of a show called Two for the Money. Really burning up the megacycles.
Nice.
Having fun doing it?
Oh, I love it.
Good.
I love to make people laugh.
I guess that's about half the battle. If you have fun doing it, it's going to turn out that way.
I don't always laugh. I just love to make
it. Incidentally, you may not remember this, but there is a connection between Sam and me. You remember the time 7 years ago when I was playing an experimental vaudeville thing someplace in Brooklyn, laying the biggest egg in the history of entertainment?
And I was scrambling.
And the audience was about to, what happened? The audience was about to come over the footlights and lynch me, and I introduced you, and you came out and saved my life.
Do you remember that? Is that the connection?
No. That has nothing to do with it. I was just reminiscing a little bit, Sam. Now let's meet the second half of your connection. Will you come in, please, gentlemen? All right. Would you tell me your name, please, and where you're from?
Marty Zimmerman.
And what do you do, Marty?
Television and radio repairing.
What's the name of the company?
MoMa TV Service.
Give yourself a plug. And where do you do that?
In Brooklyn, New York.
All right, sir. How about you?
Mickey Gold, pleater in the garment industry.
A pleater in the garment industry. Nice
from
to have
New
you.
York.
From Brooklyn. And you, sir?
George Malden, auditor.
George?
Douglas and Long Island.
Douglas and Long Island. All right, now for the benefit of our audience, let's make the connection.
20 years ago, these men were in a dance band, and Sam Levinson was the band leader.
Hard to believe. You'll never believe this. You'll just never believe this. Well, anyway, I'll give you this one little link before we get to it. This is something these men did with Sam. And we'll start the questioning with Sam Clavin. Gene Clavin.
Let's see. First of all, Mr. Zimmerman, you look a little familiar. You're not a Herb Schreiner in an incredible disguise.
No, he's not.
Okay, you fellas aren't students of Sam's?
No.
No, they're not.
Sam, I'm not doing too well here. Can I have some of your old relations? Is this a thing, a service that they did for you, Sam?
In a sense.
In a sense, it was a service, yes.
Did it have anything to do with your career as an entertainer?
I don't think so, Sam. Do you?
Very vaguely.
Did it have anything to do with their careers?
Well, it shortened them.
That's 28 hours down, 125 to go. Gloria?
Well, Sam, did you ever work with these gentlemen?
Yes, I'd work.
In their particular professions?
Well, I don't know what you mean by their...
In their professions now?
Yes.
No.
Did you...
But he did work with them.
You did work with them. Did you work together in school, perhaps?
No.
Did you, when you worked with them, was it in the entertainment profession?
Yes.
Or was it on a tour?
Yes. That's $50 down, 100 to go. Let's hear from you, Eddie.
Is this part of the old vaudeville act?
No.
No, it was never a vaudeville act.
It wasn't
no.
Vaudeville? Did you sing together, perhaps, as a quartet?
No.
Uh-uh.
Did you play instruments together? Did you work together in that way? Did you play the violin while they played the violin?
I think we'll give them the whole sum of money anyway, but Eddie, you did get it close enough. Here's the story. 20 years ago, these men played in a dance band, and Sam Levinson was the leader of the band. Have you played in the intervening 20 years?
Well, not,
together?
No, certainly not together.
Not together, no. Huh? What instrument did you play?
I played the violin. The sounds that came out didn't sound like it, but I played the violin.
And how about you, Marty? What'd you play?
Oh, I played the drums.
I see. And you?
I played the saxophone.
And you?
Piano.
Well, now, I knew this all along because we did a little research here earlier, and we got all these instruments here together. And I thought maybe the audience liked to hear this great band play. Would you like to hear them?
Oh, no.
Sure. Come on, fellas. Would you like
Gene?
To hear them play?
Gene?
Yes?
Could I have the first stand?
Okay. All right, fellas, there are the instruments right over there. Let's go over there and see what we can do. What songs were popular back in those days, Sam? Do you remember what songs you used to play?
Well, I know a couple of tunes we took off the hit of the week list. Well, I don't know. What's 20 years ago? Dinah. We played
Dinah was a big tune then.
Margie, you know.
Margie, certainly.
I think we could handle Margie. You boys
all
remember
right.
Margie?
Oh, sure. What key would you do it in? Or
what key?
Eh? All right. Incidentally, before you start, what did you call your group?
Are you ready?
Yes. Go ahead.
I'm ashamed to say that.
Now, don't be ashamed, Sam.
The Varsity Syncopators.
much as it gives me a great deal of pleasure, ladies and gentlemen, to present the renaissance of that world-famous musical group playing Margie, the Varsity Syncopators. Take it away, Sam.
Let's hear an A there first.
Let's hear an A first.
Is better than my old
for
fiddle,
the number.
All right, watch these tap walks. It's in F, Ellie. Wait. I knew there was something. You were always on that side. Go over here. Now, all right, watch the foot, boys. Remember? One, two.
The panel members had a gleam in their eye, and it was such a bright, bouncy businessman's temple. Why don't you give us one more fast chorus, and everybody come over here and dance. How about that? Come on over here.
night. The one thing I'd have to say, Sam, is you made the dance too long.
Oh, the varsity Gene, syncopator.
Grossinger's just called. They can have a split week.
Gene, yes. What's a megacycle?
Megacycle is a device on which television programs...
Good night, Gene.
No, not yet. No, wait a minute. No, not yet now. Well, it certainly was wonderful to hear that great dance band that was so popular 20 years ago. I remember it like it was yesterday. Matter of fact, I think it was yesterday. Well, right now, friends, Elsie wants you to make a connection between this product and your shopping list.
You know, Lady Borden Plantation peach ice cream is wonderful. Well, let me describe it this way. Imagine when you were young, you had a big peach tree out back, and every year you take the biggest, juiciest peaches and make peach ice cream. Remember how it looked coming off the dasher? Smooth as satin, with golden bites of peaches all the way through. Well, today, you can get that same real fruit goodness right here in Lady Borden Plantation Peach Ice Cream. Because Lady Borden Plantation Peach is made with a real fruit and with extra cream to make it extra good. Enjoy that homemade goodness real soon. Buy Lady Borden Plantation Peach, where you see this new sign. For Lady Borden is the very finest of fine ice cream.
That certainly carried me back to the good old days, and I noticed there are a few out-of-breath characters over there, too.
Yeah.
Did that carry you back to the good old days?
Oh, they're carrying me back. I'll tell you that.
I may have to carry you out of the theater. I guess it's about time to bid a fond farewell to our panel tonight. I thank you for the assistance you've given me and the fun I've had in playing Make the Connection here tonight. Hope you have a very pleasant trip back to the coast. Betty, you are going back tonight, aren't you?
Thank you, yes. As a matter of fact, I think Gloria's going back too, and we're all just evacuating the place.
You mean you're all going except old me? You're going to leave me here?
I hate to say this to Betty because it's going to seem so sort of small at this point. Betty, I'm going to Rochester.
Gloria, that's on the West Coast.
I love you in Rochester.
Gene, just
so
a word. We're glad to have you back on the air after an extended illness.
Thank
there's
you.
There's still three empty lines in my dance book.
Gene.
I am touched, indeed.
Could I ask one question?
Yes, you may.
Do you always leave your partners in the center of the floor alone?
I apologize. I really didn't mean to do that, but it was one of those things that think my liver began to give out, and I just had to leave. That's all there was to it. I'm sorry. I'll make up for it
that's
next
all right.
Week.
I think that's how Betty Hutton got into show.
Well, I got great fun.
No, you haven't.
Liver dehaven. Your liver to heaven... Good night,
Eddie.
Good night,
Eddie.
Gene. Good night, Cologne.
Thank you so much. Good night, ladies and gentlemen. Hope you'll be able to join us again next week for another session of Make the Connection. Good night.
This has been a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Transportation for Make the Connection was arranged by American Airlines, the country's leading airline. American Airlines serves 77 major cities. They'll fly you in luxurious comfort aboard DC-7 flagships. Make the Connection has been brought to you by Borden's, who invite you to try some other fine products on Elsie's Good Food line. As Elsie says, if it's Borden's, it's got to be good. Be sure to see Borden's popular daytime show, the dramatic series called Way of the World, now on at a new time. Check your paper for the new time of Way of the World over many of these same stations. And be with us again next week when Borden's presents Make the Connection.